The power of soup, the power of our words, the power of suggestion. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, I actually just did this video, put it up, and then I took it down, so I'm making another one in its place. And as you all know, I'm very particular about the words that I use. And so I wanted to kind of rephrase a couple things in this about the power of suggestion and the power of words. And I wanted to talk a little bit more in detail about it than I did in my other video. First of all, I don't give advice, suggestions, information, or recommendations. I just share with you my perspective on different topics, as is with this one. I've always grown up believing that words have power and that suggestions have power, whether we're the ones suggesting or whether we're the ones taking in the suggestion. I'm going to give you an example. One of my dear friends recommended to me a restaurant, and she said that they serve the best soup ever. Well, I don't know if she said it was the best soup ever, but she said it was the best soup. And she went on to describe it in detail and talk a lot about it and tell me how delicious it is. Well, as you all know, I quit kind of going to restaurants because I've been disappointed in a lot of restaurants. Sometimes the food isn't warm. Sometimes it's just the quality of the food is not up to my expectations. And so I prefer to cook at home. And yet, if someone recommends to me an extremely good restaurant, and I'm not talking about a pricey restaurant, I'm just talking about great food, and that the food is great and a specific item on the menu, you know, that they've tried, that they would recommend to me, then I may try it. So I don't, you know, I'm very healthy eating, and probably this soup, even though it's kind of healthy or healthy, most restaurants add salt and add ingredients that I don't eat. I'm basically vegan, and, you know, but when I do go out, I eat what I want, but I don't like hydrogenated, and I don't like added salts or added sugars for the most part. Now, sometimes I'll have dessert if it's a birthday or something like that, or I'll have a taste of a dessert. But overall, I try to stay away from refined sugars. But anyhow, this soup has stuck in my mind, this bowl of soup. The power of this bowl of soup is stuck in my mind. And of course, it's a good thing. It's not a bad thing. And yet, you know, I said, do I really need to go to this restaurant? And I thought about it, and I thought, you know, I really don't need to go there. So I don't know if indeed I will end up going to the restaurant and having this bowl of soup. If I do, I don't know when it will be. But I remember, had she never made that suggestion, had she never talked about it, it wouldn't be there in my mind. And so I believe that the power of suggestion is very important. And once we receive a power of suggestion, we have to decide, is that suggestion right for our life or is it not right for our life? Often we're not even realizing that words spoken over to us are really suggestive, suggestions to us. We often act on words or phrases or suggestions like bowl of soup. Oh, okay, I'll go try it, you know. And I think it's really important to think about the words that we use outwardly and the words that we receive inwardly. And if something has been negatively spoken to us, I believe that it's important for us to somehow find a good positive way of erasing it from our minds. And, you know, if someone said something like, well, you're dumb, well, then we kind of erase it from our mind by saying, I am smart. I am smart. I am really smart. And, you know, we've got to do that because, you know, I mean, I've heard people talk about how they were always told that they weren't smart. And here they were some of the smartest people I had ever met. But because they were told that they weren't smart, they held on to that image of themselves not being smart. And so remember, our words have power. And our words are like that bowl of soup. They can stick with us. And so we have to be very, very selective about the words that we act upon, the suggestions that we act upon. We have to think about the words that's just been used over us, to us, through us, around us. You know, words that are even indirectly around us can affect us. And we want words to affect us in a positive way. And we want our words to affect others and situations in a positive way, whether it's a relationship, people that we love, people that we're around, our jobs, our neighborhood. We want to speak positive power words. And yes, realistic words, and yet we want to approach situations from a positive point of view. Words do have power. Suggestions have power. And the power of a bowl of soup. And I'm still thinking about that bowl of soup, but I don't know if I'll go to that restaurant or not. But either way, the suggestion stuck with me. And so we have to remember to let go of suggestions that are not right for our lives and embrace good, positive suggestions that are right for our lives and right for the people around us. From my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five of my channels. And if you do, if you subscribe to all five of my channels, I will likely subscribe back to you with all five. Hope to talk to you then. May God bless you. Bye-bye.